and the house of Utsman radiallahu anhu. It was besieged for 40 days. And for 40 days Utsman radiallahu anhu would fast during the day and he would pray salah during the night. And upon the 40th night, Utsman radiallahu anhu, he saw in a dream, he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Utsman, aftir indana ghadan. He said, O Utsman, the fast that you have been keeping for 40 days, tomorrow you open your fast with us. And when Utsman radiallahu anhu woke up, his wife Anayla radiallahu anha mentions that he was in an elated mood, he was in a happy mood. And the first thing he did, he went out and he spoke to the guard and he said, Unshiduka billah. He said, I ask you for the sake of Allah, do not shed anybody's blood on my behalf. And then he took the Quran and he began to recite the Quran. And one of the rebels, they jumped over the wall. And the rebel came and he grabbed the beard of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And Utsman radiallahu anhu calmly said, Da'al lihyati kana abuka yukrimuha. He said, leave my beard, because indeed your father used to honor this beard. And the rebel, his hands clapped, because he remembered not how only his father honored, but how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and how everybody else honored Utsman radiallahu anhu. And when he heard these words, he left. And then two other Egyptians, they jumped over the wall. And they knew no virtues of Utsman. And when Utsman radiallahu anhu saw them coming, this was a man whose life is at stake. But the first thing he did, he tied his sarwal, he tied his trousers. Because he was a man of haya, he didn't want his aura to be exposed in his final moments. Upon occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting and a portion of his leg was exposed. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came in and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't move. And then Umar radiallahu anhu came and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't move. And when Uthman radiallahu anhu came, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam quickly put his clothes straight. And Aisha radiallahu anhu asked, then my father came in, a messenger of Allah, you didn't change your position. Umar came in, you didn't change your position. But when Uthman came in, you changed your position. And the Prophet ﷺ said, should I not have haya from the man that even the angels have haya from? Shouldn't I have haya from the man who even the angels have haya from? And then these rebels, they came and they struck Uthman radiallahu anhu on the head with a piece of iron. And the blood began to pour from the head of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And the first place where the blood fell was on the Quran. And where on the Quran, on the verse, say yakfikahumullah, that Allah will suffice you against them. Allah will suffice you against them. And then one of them was about to strike him with a sword. And Utsman radiallahu anhu placed his hand high to protect himself. And he cut the hand of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And Utsman radiallahu anhu said, Wallahi, innaha la awwalu yadin katabat al-Qur'an. He said, I swear by Allah, the hand that you have just cut off, it was the first hand to write the Qur'an. And then they placed the sword on the stomach of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And his wife, she came running. And she placed the hand between the sword and they cut off the finger of his wife. And then they pierced the stomach of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And after Utsman radiallahu anhu, an 82-year-old man had passed away. One of the rebels, he jumped onto the chest of Utsman radiallahu anhu. And he stabbed him 6 times. And then they dragged the body of Utsman radiallahu anhu to the rubbish tip. And their rebels were saying, no man can bury Utsman radiallahu anhu. And the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Umme Habiba radiallahu anha, she climbed onto the stairs of the Masjid Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she said, oh rebels, no, if you do not allow us to bury Utsman radiallahu anhu, then I, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I, the widow of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I, the beloved of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I, the mother of the believers, will descend into the streets of Medina with my hair uncovered, and I will bury Utsman myself. She knew that no rebel would stand in front of the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu mentions that I swear by Allah, if Umm Habiba radiallahu anha had descended into the streets of Medina with her hair covered, then Allah would have rained rocks from the sky. Allah would have rained rocks from the sky. And when the rebels heard the threat of the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they allowed the body of Utsman radiallahu anhu to be buried by four people: Hassan radiallahu anhu, Hussein, Ali radiallahu anhu, and Muhammad ibn Talha. And when they were taking the body of Utsman radiallahu anhu to have it buried, the rebels began to throw rocks. They began to throw rocks at the body of Utsman radiallahu anhu. Amrata bin Arta radiallahu anha mentions that when me and Aisha radiallahu anha came back from Hajj, we saw the Quran upon which the blood of Utsman had fell. And they say that this Quran, you can find it today in the Top Kapina Museum. She says, I saw this Quran and I saw the blood over the ayat, sayakfikahumullah, that Allah will be sufficient for you against them. And she swears by Allah that each one of these rebels died a disastrous death. Every single one of these rebels died a terrible death. See, the ill consequences of the death of Utsman radiallahu anhu was such that Hassan radiallahu anhu mentioned that I saw my grandfather, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a dream, and he was standing by the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was standing by the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he looked worried, and this was the first time that I ever saw him in a dream looking worried. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came behind him, and he placed his hand upon the shoulder of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Umar radiallahu anhu came behind him, and he placed his hand upon the shoulder of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And this was the day that Utsman radiallahu anhu passed away. And shortly after this, that Utsman radiallahu anhu came, and his face was full of blood, and his head was in his hands, and he said, O Messenger of Allah, ask these people, for what sin did they butcher me like a cow? And Hassan radiallahu anhu says that when Utsman radiallahu anhu said this, the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala began to shake, and two streams of blood came down from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day of judgment, many martyrs will come. For some martyrs, Afghanistan will give a witness. For some martyrs, Palestine will give a witness. For some martyrs, Kashmir will give a witness. For some martyrs, Iraq will give a witness. For some martyrs, the Battle of Uhud will give a witness. For some martyrs, the Battle of Badr will give witness. For Utsman ibn Affan, the Book of Allah, the Quran, will give a witness, because he passed away in front of the Quran. For Utsman ibn Affan, nothing else other than the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give witness. Every single person here knows 10th of Muharram. Every single person here knows that the 10th of Muharram was when Hussein radiallahu anhu was murdered. But how many people know when Utsman radiallahu anhu passed away? We say that Hussein radiallahu anhu was deprived of water for 3 days. But Utsman radiallahu anhu was deprived of water for 40 days. He was a man regarding who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ رَفِيقٌ يَعْنِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَرَفِيقِي Uthman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that each and every prophet will have a companion in Jannah, and my companion will be Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu.